Hello and welcome to the New Stone Tablets Part 2. We will be reading Exodus chapter 34, verses 18 through 28 today, so let's begin reading. Celebrate the festival of unleavened bread. For 7 days eat bread made without yeast, as I commanded you. Do this at the appointed time in the month of Aviv, for in that month you came out of Egypt. The first offspring of every womb belongs to me, including all the firstborn males of your livestock, whether from herd or flock. Redeem the firstborn donkey with a lamb, but if you do not redeem it, break its neck. Redeem all your firstborn sons. No one is to appear before me empty-handed. 6 days you shall labor, but on the seventh day you shall rest, even during the plowing season, and harvest you must rest. Celebrate the festival of weeks with the first fruits of the wheat harvest, and the festival of ingathering at the turn of the year. 3 times a year all your men are to appear before the sovereign Lord, the God of Israel. I will drive out nations before you and enlarge your territory. And no one will covet your land when you go up 3 times each year to appear before the Lord your God. Do not offer the blood of a sacrifice to me along with anything containing yeast, and do not let any of the sacrifice from the Passover festival remain until morning. Bring the best of the first fruits of your soil to the house of the Lord your God. Do not cook a young goat in its mother's milk. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Write down these words, for in accordance with these words I have made a covenant with you and with Israel." Moses was there with the Lord 40 days and 40 nights, without eating bread or drinking water, and he wrote on the tablets the words of the covenant, the Ten Commandments. That's our section of scripture for today. God has been speaking to Moses. Moses had to go up to Mount Sinai again because he broke the 2 stone tablets with the Ten Commandments on them. God has been speaking about not making a treaty with the people in the land they are about to go to, and now God continues with remembering to celebrate the festival of unleavened bread in verse 18. And verses 18 through 20 are somewhat reiterations of Exodus chapters 12 and 13. For instance, the first offspring of every womb belongs to God. In verse 21, you have the restating of the Sabbath rule. They work 6 days and rest one. In verse 22 through 23, God mentions more festivals for them to celebrate. All of the men are to appear before God 3 times a year, and the promise is that no one will covet their land if they do so. And I like verse 26, it says this, bring the best of the first fruits of your soil to the house of the Lord your God. We should do the same. We don't make the same sacrifices, but let's give our best time and energy to God. And verse 26 does continue, though, with something strange. Do not cook a young goat in its mother's milk. I actually heard this from a friend recently. I looked into it. It does seem to be the case. The reason this is in there, it seems, is because other nations would use this in pagan worship. So God wanted them to be set apart. And I've heard of some other explanations of that verse as well, but that seems to be the best. And now in verses 27 through 28, let's talk about a contradiction in the Bible. I think these are fun. Sometimes Christians can feel threatened by this stuff, but I enjoy it. It's like a mystery, you know? And so what's the contradiction? Here in Exodus chapter 34, it says that Moses wrote on 2 stone tablets and not God. But if we look at Deuteronomy 10, this chapter has a different depiction of the same event. This is verses 1 and 2. It says this, "At that time, the Lord said to me, chisel out 2 stone tablets like the first ones and come up to me on the mountain. Also make a wooden ark. I will write on the tablets the words that were on the first tablets, which you broke. Then you are to put them in the ark." Then verse 4, "The Lord wrote on these tablets what he had written before, the Ten Commandments." So is this a contradiction? Because it might seem like, okay, maybe God wrote on the tablets the first time, but then the second time Moses wrote on them. But now in Deuteronomy 10, it seems like we have that God wrote on the tablets. And then in Exodus 34, in those ending verses there, it seems like maybe Moses did. Is this a contradiction? No. In Exodus 34, 1, God says he will write the Ten Commandments on the tablets. So that is in line with Deuteronomy 10. So what did Moses write? Well, verse 27 says, write down these words. What are these words? Well, what we talked about this time and last time are about making treaties, festivals, and so forth. You do have some Sabbath rules, which is part of the Ten Commandments. But we hadn't been just talking about the Ten Commandments. So what's the answer? I think it's this. God wrote the Ten Commandments himself, and Moses just wrote these various rules. So there you go. Some think it's a contradiction, but I would say that is the answer. So isn't that fun? Application. Don't be afraid of contradictions. Don't be afraid of questions. Look into these things. I think a pursuit of all this deepens your faith. I don't think turning a blind eye to things like this does anybody any good. And here's the reality. Sometimes we have questions and it takes a little while to get the answers. Maybe you'll even have to wait until we get to heaven to ask, but let's pursue God for these answers and deepen our faith as we do so. So let's pray and we'll close this video out today. Lord God, we just thank you and praise you. And I just pray, Lord God, that you would deepen our faith today. And maybe there's somebody listening that has a particular question that they've been pursuing from you for some time. Lord God, I just pray that you would give that answer. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.